I'm Teresa Travitello with another exciting edition of Showcase Ocean Pines. Check out these scenes from our visit to the Kiwanis annual duck race held at Frontiertown last month and the Ocean Pines Police Bike Rodeo for Kids. Let's take a look. We're here at the Kiwanis annual duck race. We were feeling lucky, we got a ducky, and we got some great food I'm standing in line for. Stay tuned for some more.
And I got everything in one fell swoop. Desserts,
Isn't that wonderful?
So tell us about the duck race.
All right, we started working this back in June. This is our 8th annual one. We will probably raise somewhere between $2,000 to $3,000. That will give away in scholarships to students from Worcester County and Salisbury School. We've been selling tickets since June. It's going real well. Thank goodness we have a good day. Last year we had a tropical storm. This year, well, at least it's not raining, and we hope to have a successful race. We'll be racing approximately a little over 1,000 ducks to get our win.
That is great. So what are you guys doing now?
Waiting to see if we win.
Oh yeah, they get rid of all the winners right now?
Yeah.
Okay, what's first prize?
I have no idea.
Okay, first prize, $1,500. Second prize, $300. Third, $150. Fourth prize, $50. Plus additional prizes. What are you going to do with the money if you win it?
I'm not sure.
You just want to win the money. And then you'll decide later, right?
Yep.
Have you guys ever
buy a golf cart.
Golf cart? How about you?
New iPod.
All right. You got, that, Mom?
Hello, it's Carol and Kriki Weiderman from the Kiwanis Club, and we're here at the annual duck race, having a blast. The ducks just finished, and they're being dried off, and the numbers are going to be pulled pretty soon. Got to go, because we're going to win.
I would like to thank the owner of this fine facility for allowing the Kiwanis Club of Ocean Pines, Ocean City to use this facility for our duck race. I think this is our 8th year, and without it, we could not do this enterprise that we have and make it a success. We'd like to thank George, and we present him with this gift certificate for allowing us to use the pool. Thanks again, George. Thank you. Thanks again.
Today we're out here with Chief Dave Massey, the annual bike rodeo. Chief, you want to tell us a little bit about the program?
Yeah, our bike rodeo is to educate parents and kids on how to safely operate their bikes. We're partnering with Worcester County Health Department and the 4-H Club Worcester County to reinforce the laws for parents, the skills for kids. We have an obstacle course for kids to safely drive their bikes and provide helmets to those parents and kids that don't have helmets. Maryland law requires kids to wear helmets if they're 12 years old or under. So we're just out here today to promote safety and to educate parents and kids on how to properly use their bikes.
That's great. What is there a particular rule or law that you think people have a myth about bike riding?
Yeah, one of the biggest myths is to ride your bike against traffic. Yeah, in Maryland, you have to obey all the traffic laws. So you have to go with the flow of traffic. You have to stop at stop signs. It's just like you're in a car. So the myth that you ride against traffic, it's actually more dangerous to ride against traffic because you're closing speed and you're going against each other. So you actually increase the speed of an accident when you're going against the flow of traffic. So it's much safer. And we have a bike lane it's really called an improved shoulder in Ocean Pines. And that's where bikes should safely operate, in that improved shoulder, that little marked lane on the side of the road. And try and stay within that Again, stop at stop signs, yield to vehicles when you have to yield to a vehicle, and also obey all traffic laws.
Great. What kind of kids, what ages are going to be out here today learning about all these skills?
Well, we're hopefully going to have some trikes, some kids that are very small on tricycles, and then we're going to have bicycles. There's really no age limit, and we're just trying to promote it for kids in general.
All right. Hi, we're talking with Chuck Taylor of the Ocean Pines Police Department. Why don't you give us a little demonstration today? Tell us a little bit about the course.
It's just an obstacle course that the 4-H group has set up in Worcester County Health Department. It's a basic course that you go through. It's got stop signs, a little bit of a weave and go, and then a long stay in a straight line. It's pretty easy, but once the kids go through it, they like it a lot. So it's the second year we've done this.
And give us a little sample.
I'll see what I can do.
All right, let's go. That was some really great riding, Officer Taylor. Be sure to mark your calendars to be a part of these events next year. To learn more about events and activities in Ocean Pines, turn your TV to MediaCom Channel 78 or visit our website, www.oceanpines.org, and get involved in the community fun. Thank you for watching Showcase Ocean Pines.